You've chosen answer B, that the flow will extend out further if the flow is laminar, and if the flow is turbulent, it won't travel out as far from the tube exit. To try to justify this answer, let's set up two points on the same streamline, point one at the free surface and point two at the free jet. Let's apply the energy equation between these two points and simplify it. The pressure at P1 and P2 is atmospheric pressure in both cases. The velocity at point one is essentially zero, the tank diameter is so large that the water level doesn't go down at an appreciable rate. And Z2 is equal to zero at the center line of our tube. Additionally, the velocity through the pipe that we ought to be using for the major loss is the same as the velocity at point two, so I'll draw a subscript two here. And the same thing is true for the minor loss at the entrance of the tube. Here I've rearranged this expression, solving for V2 and setting Z1 equal to H. And let's consider the fact that the tube itself is very long, extending from the bottom of the tank. So if the tube is very long with respect to its diameter, this term in the middle in the diameter tends to be very large, and both alpha and the minor loss coefficients tend to be negligibly small in this case. And what that says is a higher friction factor will reduce the velocity at point two, and a low friction factor would result in a relatively high velocity at point two. If the flow is laminar, the friction factor is equal to 64 over the Reynolds number, or in this case, the friction factor is about 0.0006 if the flow is laminar. If the flow is turbulent, you could look up on a Moody chart for a smooth tube or a smooth pipe. You'll find the friction factor is about equal to 0.04 if the flow is turbulent. And what that says is if the flow is turbulent, F is relatively large, is larger than if it was laminar. Consequently, that reduces the velocity at point two. And indeed, the correct answer here is that the flow will extend out further if it's laminar flow and not quite as far if it was turbulent. Physically, what's occurring, if the flow is turbulent, there's a great deal of viscous loss down the length of the pipe. And the viscous losses remove mechanical energy from the fluid as it flows down, causing the fluid velocity to reduce. Conversely, if it was laminar, nice smooth flow, viscous losses are not nearly as great, and you see a stream that extends much further from the exit of the tube. The difference in velocities at point two when the flow transitions from turbulent to laminar suggests that the Reynolds number also changes. And that's true. The average Reynolds number is about 3,000, but when it transitions to laminar flow, the Reynolds number actually goes up a little bit because of the reduction in the viscous losses. That causes the Reynolds number to go up a little bit, and then in that case it transitions to turbulent flow. And counterintuitively, the decrease in the Reynolds number causes the fluid to transition from laminar to turbulent, and it tends to oscillate back and forth. So this is an example of an unstable situation.